गुड मॉर्निंग। Okay, so we started with the React JS in last lecture, and today we'll continue with that. Today I'll show you the code also, how to create application and how it works, and what are the what is the structure of the application that you create for the React. So everything will start with that. So let us do one thing. First of all, let me share my screen. Is it visible? Okay. Now, can you see this VS code? Fine. So you can see that I have one folder called React, and I have installed necessary stuff. Like I have installed Node.js framework, I mean Node.js package, and which includes npm and everything. So if you just want to check, let's show here node.v, that is version. So currently I have this version of Node and npm. So these are the current version for Node and npm which I have, and then I installed that create React app. I hope you remember create React app package is required to create React app. And now I want to create some application. So let us create React app here. So currently I am in this React folder. Let me create that app. Okay. So the command says create React app. Let's say app 01. I want to create this app. I think both commands works actually. Let us try. Okay. Fine. So let us try with this npx. Because see, what I saw today on internet, that it is working without npx also. So I thought let me try, but it is not working. So let us try with this. Before that, let me do clear screen, and then let us try this. Fine. So it is not working without npx. I don't know why, but on internet I saw this thing that it was showing it. Maybe it was the reason of different versions, I guess. Whatever it is, but you, as I told you, it is going to take some time to create new application. It is going to take some time. In fact, few minutes it will take. So let us wait for that time, because it is going to install number of Node packages and Node modules and all those things related to React. I'll show you the structure also, what kind of structure it creates when you create React app. So meanwhile, let us discuss what is already covered. What we discussed in last lecture, we started with this React introduction, right? And then we discuss getting started, where we discuss about how to install the things which are required, how to create applications. So currently we have fired this particular command, right? And it is taking some time. Fine. And then we discuss how you can start running this application with the help of npm start command. Within that directory, you can do that. Okay, then we discuss about rendering the HTML, where we discuss Zuzal, that you need to try, because the mainly NPX, what it does using NPX, when you start any application, when you run any package, it is not going to download everything and going to save it. It is going to do it in temporary folder. But you can try with NPM also. I'm not sure. Okay. And we discussed this render function, which is actually rendering. When you say react-dom.render, and then you provide two arguments mainly, what you want to render and where you want to render. So where it means it is the real DOM, and what is part of your virtual DOM. Okay, so if you remember in React, React itself creates one virtual DOM, which is going to be mapped on the real DOM. So that is render function we discussed. Then this is JSX actually. I hope you remember that this is not pure HTML. This is just JSX, right? And we have talk about JSX also. So next is JSX. And JSX is nothing but JavaScript XML. It's a special type of syntax which allows to write HTML in React. And of course, JSX is not the compulsion. Without JSX also, you can write your code with the help of React libraries. But JSX makes your job easy. That's why we prefer JSX. And one more thing. Okay, I'll show you. Let me show one thing here. There is some lagging. Babel.io. I guess that is the name. Babeljs.io, if I'm not wrong. This is one JavaScript compiler. Okay. And let me do something here. Let me show you what happens when you use JSX. So meanwhile, our application is getting ready. Meanwhile, it is being created. Let us try this. Okay, fine. So now let us write some JSX here. Let us say I want to create some element, and I create using JSX syntax, right? This is one compiler, and you can see behind the scene what is created. When you use JSX, right? When it gets compiled, in fact, internally it is using react.createElement. This is the method that it is using. Which element it is creating? It is creating H1 element, and it has the content hello world. Okay, something like that. Let us create something else. PA constant ELE equal to any other problem? Let us remove this part and let's create something else. Within that, let's create P and then say hello world. Let us see what it creates. When we have this kind of what happened? Oh, there is the syntactical error. Fine. Yeah. So now you can see again, it is calling react.createElement. And then the third argument, again, it is another element. So this is nested elements. You can see that, right? So you can see that compiler, your JavaScript compiler, when you use JSX, how it does it. It is internally using React library. So react.createElement. So that is something that I wanted to show you. Fine. So I hope by this time, yes, our application is ready now. And you can see that how much time it has taken. So now this is my application and it contains different things, right? So let's see what it contains. The main thing is node modules, and this is our library. These are the required libraries that we need. See, you can see Babel is there inside. This is the Babel compiler, which we have just seen, which converts your JSX into React library form. So all these required libraries are there. So this node modules will remain there. Then you have this public folder, which contains all those resources or assets that you want to disclose, that you want to show publicly without any restrictions, which includes index.html also. Okay, and some logos are there, which you may be using in this application. Then you have this icon also, right? So this is our public directory. And then finally, you have the source directory, which contains all your code, mainly that JS code and CSS code. You can see here CSS file, JS file, then testing file is there, which we are not right now going to work with. Okay, index.css and index.js. I hope you remember I told you that in React, there are two main or the two important files, that is index.html, which is going to display, and then index.js, which contains all this React related stuff. So we'll see that also. Then you have logo.svg file. Then you have this test related stuff. Then you have this report web vitals. Basically, this is regarding performance measure, which we are not going to do right now. Okay. But these are the different things. One of the important thing is app.js, which creates one function. Okay. There are two ways to create components. Now, let me again remind you that in React, everything is based on components. Whatever GUI you want to represent, whatever GUI you want to show, everything is one component. Okay. We will be creating component for that. Even if it is a button, we can create component for that. So there are two ways to create components. One is using ES6 classes, or you can use function components. By default, this newer version of React, when it creates this app.js, inside that it creates one the main component, that is app component, and it is creating using function. In using function, but I hope you remember that in JavaScript, function is at the, I mean, classes, ES6 classes, at the end, it is nothing but a function. So whether you write ES6 class to create component or you write function, ultimately both are same. Okay, of course, there are some syntactical differences that you need to remember. There are some differences that if you want to use function to create component, then you need to use hooks for that to work with state objects. But it becomes easy when you use classes as components to work with state objects. Now, what is state objects and all those we'll discuss. Don't worry. Okay. But ultimately, this function app, it returns. And what it returns? Nothing but. Can you tell me what it returns? What is this? What is this? JSX. Exactly. This is not HTML. This is JSX syntax, right? This is JSX syntax. So it is there. And if you see index.js, ultimately what index.js does, it simply called React DOM.render. This React DOM is the, it is representing that virtual DOM, and then it calls render method. So it is going to render what? It is going to render this stuff, this element, this JSX. Okay. It is going to render this part inside this element. Okay. This strict mode, we'll see, we'll discuss strict mode later on. Basically, it is used to make sure that whatever you want to render, that is through strict mode, and it is going to identify some problems. If there are some problems, they will be identified. But what kind of problems this strict mode will identify, what it allows, what it does not, that we will discuss later. Okay, even if you remove right now, it's okay, fine, it will work. So basically, you can see that now, this looks like some HTML tag, app, it looks like some HTML tag, but it is the component. Okay, it is the component. What are you trying to ask, Harsh? No social engineering in strict mode? What do you mean by that? Yeah. No, no. What do you mean by social engineering in this? I don't understand your term, social engineering, in this particular part. Basically, it is strict mode. I hope you remember strict mode in JavaScript also, which checks all the syntax and certain things it don't allow, right? Especially by default, global variables are referred with the window object, but in strict mode, it is undefined. Okay, so maybe I am not aware of that social engineering term that you are using in this context. So I need to check what you are talking about, whether it is allowed in strict mode or not. Okay, we'll see that. We'll see that social engineering part. Okay, fine. So what I was discussing now, this app, it seems like you have created a new HTML tag. It seems like that, though it is not exactly HTML tag, it is JSX. Okay. And basically, it is component that you are importing from this app.js file. This is how you can. I hope in another half of this syllabus, Prasanth sir must have discussed modules, ES6 modules, how to export and import modules. Has it been discussed in other half, especially in TypeScript or Angular? ES6 modules. Yeah. Okay, so yes, in Angular might be right. I hope you remember that default export and named export and all those stuff. Do you know that? What is default export? Okay, fine. So this is regarding that. Here you are importing from, you are importing React from the React module. You are importing React DOM from React DOM module. Okay. Then you are importing from index.css, everything you are importing from this. Then you are importing app from the, and if you see again app.js at the end, you are exporting that app class or app function rather. Here it is a function. You are exporting it as default. You are exporting it as default. Okay. Okay, so where we were. Okay. So finally, this app, you are using it here, and when you run this now application, this app component that you have just created, okay, this app component, what it contains? It contains division with the class name app, header class name, okay, some images are there, logo. Basically, you can see this is the expression that you can use within JSX. Okay, if you want to use some logo, okay, logo is here. You can see that it is some object that you can directly use within this curly braces in JSX. We are going to discuss this part also. And otherwise, it seems very much like HTML. This JSX seems like HTML, though it is not HTML. But all this will be executed. So let me just run this now. For that, I need to go inside that. Why it is showing like this? Okay. Let us go inside app01. And now we need to say npm. Start, which will start our application. So this is the default server port. Okay. So this is default application. And all this logo and all this are coming from here. You can see that logo comes from here. Then this edit, then this src app.js and save to reload. This comes from this paragraph, right? This learn React hyperlink, it comes from this, right? You can see that. So this is default application. Whenever you create any node application, by default, it is like this. Okay, and apart from this folders, now there are something like git ignore, dot git ignore. It contains those things which should not be used while you share this project on git. Okay, then package log.json and package json. This contains certain properties of this application, so that is, we are less concerned about that. And this is related to your markdown. This is a markdown file. When you put your project on GitHub, what should be, I mean, I hope you remember that whenever you put any project on GitHub or Git, basically it requires some README file. It contains some readme file to explain about your application. So this is that file. Let us see, is there any, I mean, it is showing something here. You can, of course, you can update this file as per the application that you are creating. So on Git, you require such file, right? That's why it is created by default. So this is the structure of the application which is created when you use that create React app package to create React application. But not everything is necessary here. This is the most important thing because this contains all the libraries required. Public contains all those assets which you want to display, and source contains all the source files that you are going to create. If you want, you can delete all these files and you can start from scratch. Okay, you can start from scratch. That is also allowed. Are you getting up to this point? Okay, so fine. So this is part of it. Now, let us go from here and let us create our first component. Let us start with the components because this is the heart of the React application. Everything is in form of component. Okay, so components are independent and reusable bits of code. They serve the same purpose as JavaScript functions, but work in isolation and return HTML via a render function. This is important. HTML, it will return HTML, but via render function. So there is a render function which is there. Now, if I again show you this component here, this app component, which has function app. So this is app is component and it returns HTML. Basically it returns JSX, which is similar to your HTML. Okay, so this app and there is no render function shown here, right? There is no render function shown here, but when you create component using function, you need not to create render function because render function, I mean, we don't create function within function. Okay. If you want, you can do that, but we normally don't want to do that. And today we'll see how you can create component using ES6 class. And when you use ES6 class, inside that you have a render function which return something like this. Okay, so at that time you will understand. So let us create a class component. So when creating a React component, the component's name must start with an uppercase letter. Okay, so these are some rules. If you see here again, this is also function, but it starts with capital A, as it is a component, it represents component. So that is why it must start with capital letter. The component has to include the extends react.component statement. Okay, now if you want to create component, now here if you see, it is not extending it because this is not a class. So we can compare it with here. So this rules that we are discussing right now, they are for the class component. When you use ES6 class to create component, at that time you need to do this. So class that you create, it has to extend React.component. Okay, and how to do that we'll see. This statement creates an inheritance. As you know, when you extend something, it is inheritance, and it gives your component access to React.components function. So whatever functions are there in React.components, that will be accessible. And the component also requires a render method, and this method returns HTML. So you can see a simple thing. This is a ES6 class that you create in JavaScript in your JS file. Class car extends react.component, and then it has a render function which returns actual JSX. It returns JSX. Okay. So let us create our own component. Okay, let's do that. So let me do one thing. Let me remove all this stuff. We don't require all this thing. So let us remove this. Okay, I think I need to do it like this. And let us remove this part. Okay. Now I'm going to create my own component. Okay. So let us create that component here. Again, this is not there. So let us remove this part. This app is not there. So let us remove this part also. Other things are there. Fine. Let it be. And let us create. Okay, fine. Right now it is showing some error because, okay, somewhere app. Yeah, we are using app here. So let us remove this part. Anything else? Define. We are using it. So that's why it is showing that. Okay. Now there is nothing right now to be shown here. If you see index.html, currently it is having this. And we are going to show something here. So let us create our component and let's show that component within this division. That is our job. That is what we want to do. So for that, let us create first our component. And normally to create components, the best way is to first you create one folder. Why? Because though here in this simple application, we'll be creating one or two components, but in your real world application, you will be creating number of components. And it is always a good idea to create some namespace like this. So let us create components folder. And within that, let's create a file and let's call it. Let's take the same example that is there. Not this. Car. Fine. So let us create this car component. So let's create car component names. Normally we use this capital. This is a file name. This is not a component name. And if you want, you can create JS. If you want, you can create JSX. But ultimately we are going to return JSX. So fine. This is a okay. Now, again, there is one extension that you can use. Okay, simple React snippet that will help you to provide some code snippets. So let us first install that and I'll show you what it does for you. Now let's say I want to import something. Let's say I want to import React and component because I want to create that I'm going to use that component class from the React to create my car class. So that is IMRC. It's a short form, and when you after typing IMRC, when you say enter, you can see that it has built this code. It has provided this code, import React and component from React. And if another thing is IMRD, that is for React DOM. If you want to use it, you can do it, but we don't want to use it here because React DOM, we will be using index.js where we are going to render. Here we are not going to render. Okay, but what I am going to do is now I am going to create a component, which is class component. So for that shortcut is CC and say, and you can see that it is asking you what name you want to provide. Let us say car. I hope you are aware of this multi cursor idea. Are you aware of this multi cursor point? And once you escape, it will come out of that fine. So now you can see that. And in fact, I have already imported this component explicitly. I can remove this part here. Fine. This is okay. Okay. What is the difference between these two different imports? Import within curly bracket and import without curly braces. So what is the difference between these two? I hope you know that. It's a React is the default, correct? Default export. And this is a named export. This is the named export, right? So that's why you need to import it like this. So you are aware of that. Fine. That's good. Now, very simple. You can see that I'm creating one class which extends component. Okay. Which is from the React. And it has one method called render. And this render method, whatever you want to write here, you can write, let us say H1. And between that, let us fill something. Hello, React World. Okay. And finally, you export that car component as default component. You export this car component as, so basically I have created one simple component. I have created one simple component and I am exporting it. And I want to use this component in my index.js. So first I need to import that. Import, let's say car from, what should I write? What should I write? Dot slash package name components. Dash car. Anyways, this is where we are importing it from, because in component folder, within components folder, is this the correct spelling? Components, yeah. Within components folder, we have created this car.jsx, JSX or JS, whatever you want, you can create that. Okay. So this car dot, and then we are exporting that car. We are exporting that car. So we need to say import car. This can be anything because it's a default export. So you can use any name for this car, but I'm using the same name. And from this particular file, we are importing it. And now I just want to use it. That's it. This is my component that I want to use. In CA car.jsx, you are creating this class car. And when you say export default car, so this car becomes your component. This car becomes your component because you are extending car class from the component class. You are importing it from React library. You are importing it from React library, which is there in node modules, somewhere there. Is it clear? Okay, Priyank is asking how to return. If you want to return multiple lines, we have already seen what you can do. You can do like this. I hope you remember this syntax, Priyank. Yeah. So this is how you end. One more thing. When you return, make sure that you have a single, single element as a parent element. And within that, you put all other elements. You can't do something like this. And then, no, it is not allowed, right? See, what is the error? Is it showing it here? JSX expression must have one parent element, right? You can wrap it within D, you can wrap it in within some other elements, doesn't matter. But it must be wrapped within certain. You can wrap it within React fragments also, which is nothing but blank kind of stuff. Okay, what is React fragment? You can do something like this and these are the React fragments. That's kind of empty tag, something like that. This is also allowed. And now if you do something like this, then it's fine. Then it is working. Are you getting? Okay. So let's keep this simple right now. Okay, so let us keep this simple. And now in index.js, I am going to import and then I am going to use it. So now you can see this React DOM, which is your virtual DOM, it is going to render this car component in my root component, which is there in my HTML file. So in this, within this div, this JS file is going to render car component. So let us see the output. What happened? Are we missing something? we need to save index.js, right? So it is hello React world. And if you see, if you inspect this, what can I show? Elim inspector. Yeah. See where it is. This is our root element, and within root element, this H1 is placed. This H1 is placed as normal HTML within this root element, which you have in index.html. So within this root, this car element, and car basically what it returns this. So it is placed here. Are you getting this? Everyone, are you getting this? Okay. So let's continue with our component. So this is the same example. And then it says create a function component. If you want to, okay, Yash has some question. How in this have index.js is, that is the point. How, because we are not mentioning any script in index.html. So that is the library. That is the framework, React framework. That is React library. It is going to combine this two. It is going to relate this two. So whatever you write in index.js, that will be used in index.html. That is why you cannot even change the name. That is a configuration, right? Yeah, it is with React. With React, it is, this is how it works. So fine, that is one thing. Now create a function component. We have seen how you can create class component. Now let us see how to create function component. Here is the same example as above, but created using function component. So basically nothing but, instead of writing class and extending from component, you simply say function car and then return your JSX. That's it. Okay. So it is the same thing. Let me just show it here. You can see that they are putting everything in a same file in the index.js. They are putting that component. We have put that component in a separate file, but both way it works fine. Both way it works. So that is there. Then you, if you want, you can, as you know, class can have constructor. So you can have constructor in your component class, but when you use constructor, okay, make sure that you call the super constructor also. So that is there. So if there is a constructor function in your component, this function will be called when the component gets initiated. We are going to talk about lifecycle also. At that point, you will understand when this component constructor will be called and what are the other methods that will be called. So lifecycle is there. We will discuss. The constructor function is where you initiate the component's properties. Now, car is one component that we have created. And if you create constructor function within car, normally what is the purpose of constructor in any class? What is the normal purpose of any constructor in the class? Yes. If you know object oriented, what is the purpose of constructor? Initialization, right? To initialize some of the properties of that class, of that object. So that is exactly what you are going to do in this constructor. So the constructor function is where you initiate the component's properties. In React, component properties should be kept in an object called state. Now, till now we have seen that component class contains render function. It must have render function, which returns some JSX or HTML, right? Now, component class can have state object. It's a JavaScript object, something like that, JavaScript object, right? And this state object contains some properties of that component. We will learn this state later on. The constructor function is always, function is also where you honor the inheritance of the parent component by including this super statement. I hope you know, you remember this super constructor, right? And it should be the first statement. Shayan, is that we will discuss when we will discuss state in detail, because when you use function as component, okay, state, you need to handle the state differently because state object is not there. You need to handle it differently. For that, hooks concept is there. So first we will complete our discussion with the help of class component, and at the end we will discuss function component. At that time you will understand what is the difference. So which executes the parent component constructor function, and your component has access to all the functions of the parent component. And what is parent component? That is react.component. So this is the same example. And now you can see here in our car component, there is a constructor function, which also calls super. And then this is one object. This dot state is one object. State is one object, which initializes the properties for this car object. And one property we create color, and then value is red. And this is JavaScript object. You can see that this is JavaScript object. Okay. And then you have a render method. Okay. Now, can we use this color property of this car while rendering? So it is simple. You can do something like this. This is embedding expression. Okay. You can use JavaScript objects, variables, everything within JSX. This is JSX. So within JSX, I can use JavaScript variables and its objects and all those with the help of curly braces. So within curly brace, you can say this dot state dot color. This is how you refer it. And this will be evaluated. This will be evaluated at runtime. And this will be evaluated to value red. Okay, so let us just add this part in our example. In our car, let's do something like this. So constructor is there, and let's call super. And then let's create this dot state. It is one JavaScript object with color equal to red. Okay, same example. And state is not keyword, it's a fixed object. State is a fixed object for components. For any component that you create, state is a fixed object. And that is nothing but JavaScript object, which itself contains different properties. Okay. And let us change this part. I am a, and then you can put which kind of car I am. This dot state dot color. So we saved this, and let's refresh this. So you can see I am a red car. And if you want, you can see it here. See, is it visible, everyone? Can you see the change? Okay, so that is there. And then there is another concept called properties. Now there are two things: states and property. State is nothing but it is going to hold all the properties of your component. But when you want to provide these properties while calling that component, like HTML attributes, then they are called props. Okay, let me show you that. Another way of handling component properties is by using props. So props are like function arguments. It is like function arguments, and you send them into the component as attributes. Because normally, let's say when you want to send something to anchor tag, HTML anchor tag, we want to send that link. How we send that to that anchor tag? What is the attribute we use there? href is the attribute, right? So similarly, to car component, if you want to send some attribute to that car, let's say you want to send color attribute, maybe. So you can send it through this props. I mean, you can handle it through this props. So we will learn this props in detail, but this is simple example. So use an attribute to pass a color to the car component and use it in the render function. Okay, so let me show it here. It's not showing. Maybe here? No. Yeah, this one. While calling car component, you pass some attributes, say color red. Where this color red will be saved. So by default, it will be saved. You can see there is no state, there is no component, there is no constructor, nothing. So where this attribute value will be saved when you pass it to this component car. So automatically it will be saved in props object. It's a default object. Like state is a default object. Similarly, props is a default object for any component. So you can see I am a this dot props, no more state, this dot props dot, what is the name of the property? Color. So again, this will be replaced with this. Are you getting? But what is difference between state and props? We will see. Don't worry, we will discuss that in detail. Okay, we will discuss that in detail. Are you getting up to this point? And they are showing components in components. That is also possible. We can refer to components inside other components. That is also possible. You can see here, one is a car component, another is a garage component. Within garage component, whatever you render, whatever you return, while returning, you can use some other existing component. That is also allowed. So while returning from one component, render method, whatever you are rendering, within that you can use another existing component. So that is allowed. I hope it is clear. I hope this thing is clear. And finally, they are showing components in files, which we have already seen. Okay, React is all about reusing code, and it can be smart to insert some of your components in separate files, which we have already done. So you can create .js or .jsx, both works. To make it more general, you can use .js. Okay, note that the file must start by importing React as before, and it has to end with the statement export default car like this. Start with this import statement React and end with this. Okay, so we have already created a separate file and we are using it as component. So they are showing it here at the end. So we have done this, right? We have already done this. That is how we are doing it. Are you getting up to this point? Okay, we have 6 minutes, so I guess we can complete this props. Let us do it. What is props? I just discussed props. That is short form for the properties. So component attributes that you want to handle within component, it is automatically set as the part of the properties object. So props are arguments passed into React components. And props are passed to components via HTML attributes. We have seen that example, like this brand equal to for, it will be automatically set inside props object of component, default props object of component. So React props are like function arguments in JavaScript and attributes in HTML. Thus, to send props into component, use the same syntax as HTML attributes. This is the same syntax as HTML attribute. The component receives the argument as a props object. Okay, now this is interesting. Whatever you pass here, how it will be received by this car component, it will be received as the argument as a props object. So there is no nothing regarding props here. You are not defining it, but it is default object for any component. So you can say this dot props dot brand. Okay, so you can see it here. We have already run this, right? We have already run this. So brand, this will be I am a Ford. Why? Because I am a, and then this dot props dot brand, and brand is this. Props are also how you pass data from one component to another as parameter. So let us see another example of that. You can see that here we are using this dot props dot brand. Okay, and in garage, when you render, when you use car, while using car, you just say, I want to use Ford brand. And then you are passing it here and it is stored in the props object. So similar example, I mean, how you can use it with the nested components, it is showing that part. If you have a variable to send and not a string, as in the example above, see here we are sending string. Here we are sending string. But if you have a variable, JavaScript variable to send, you just put the variable name inside curly braces. Okay, what you need to do, let's say, which function you are talking about, Zuzer? Function component? That we will see. Right now, don't focus on function component. Purely focus right now on this class component. Okay. Function component is little different, so we will handle it there afterwards. So you can see that here. Fine. This is same. This part is same. But now I don't want to pass. Still, I want to pass for. But it is now no more direct string. It is a variable, constant basically. Within this function, it will remain constant. So car name equal to Ford, and I want to send this value, not this direct value. So here I can use it within curly brackets. Actually, why you can do this? Because this is nothing but JSX. And in JSX, if you want to evaluate your expression at runtime, whether it can be JavaScript variable or object, you can do like this. Within curly brackets, you put that name, and it will be sending the value Ford. And final result will be same. Final result will be same. Or if it was an object, see, it can be an object also. Let's say car info. This is JavaScript object, which has two properties, name and model. So you can put here car info, and here you can get it like this. Because brand is the property for car component. Value of brand is JavaScript object. So you can refer it like this, this dot props dot branch dot model, and model refers Mustang. Okay. It refers this value. So if you run this, you can print it. I am Mustang. Okay. And this comes from here. Does this make sense? Are you getting this? Okay. And then finally, props in the constructor. So if your component has a constructor function, the props should always be passed to the constructor and also to the react.component via the super method. So when you, if you have constructor, then you must pass props here. Not must, but it says should. You should always pass, because this props you can use to instantiate your state objects that we will see. You can use this props values to instantiate your state object. And you should also do this. Okay, you should also do this. So this is the same example. React, okay, one more important note. React props are read only. This props object is read only. You will get an error if you try to change their value. Okay, so let us try this. Let me put this constructor. Oh, it is already there. So let's just put here props and props. And what else? Okay, and we need to, while we call it, we need to pass it here. Let us pass that here. Are you getting this? I am a Mustang car. Got the point? Okay, let us do one small thing here. Let's check. What if we don't pass props here? Actually, you should do that. But if we don't do that, there is no error. And I hope this should not be a problem. So you can see that it says you should, right? It says you should. Props should always be passed to the constructor, not must. Even if you don't pass, it will work. But why you should do it? Because further we will see state objects, And normally these props are used, props values are used to initialize state objects. That is the purpose. Okay. So this is how you can do it. Are you getting up to this point? All of you, are you getting up to this point? Okay. So further we will continue and we will discuss state and events and forms and all those stuff. Okay. Whatever is left, we will continue in the next lecture.